So today concept test development. In this first concept use case, very very important concept, madam. Use case document prepared by business analyst BA. Use case document prepared by business analyst. Based on FRS he will prepare the use case document. Based on FRS he will prepare the use case document. Whenever you are working with any software company, that company people will be give you FRS as well as use case document also. So after getting use case document only we can understand the requirements very clearly. Without use case document we can't understand the requirements very clearly. So if you get only FRS we can't understand the requirements very clearly. After getting use case document only we can understand the requirements very clearly. So this use case document is very very important for understanding the requirements. For understanding the requirements, this use case document prepared by business analyst, he will prepare based on FRS. This is very very important to understand the requirements. Only if you get only FRS, we can't understand the requirements very clearly. Today we will discuss only requirements. What is customer expecting? Why he is saying, like we will discuss now. Right. I will show you use case document prepared by business analyst. What is use case? Use case is nothing but it will describe all the functionalities in the application. It will describe all the functionalities in the application. Functionalities in the application. It will describe all the functionalities in the application. For example, user, if you do any action, what is response coming to clearly it will describe here in this section. Okay. For example, user or actor, if you do any action, what is the response coming? It will describe here in this section, that is use case document. Actor, if you do any action, what is response coming? Clearly it will show you here only. So that is use case document. For example, customer is saying add button should work fine. Customer simply is saying add button should work fine. That is customer requirement. Customer requirement is add button should work fine. Customer requirement is add button should work fine. That is the customer requirement. Based on the requirement, business analyst he will prepare use case like just take 10 in the place of value 1, just take 10 in the place of value 1, just take 20 in the place of value 2. If you click on add button, result must be 30. So which one you can understand requirement very clearly? Customer is said add button should work fine. Only he said only one line. But business analyst is writing use case like just take 10 in the place of value 1, just take 20 in the place of value 2. If you click on add button, result must be 30. So just we will take 10 in the place of value 1, just we will take 20 in the place of value 2. If I click on add button, 30 is coming or not. This is our task. So work will be very easy. So that's the reason all the software companies, they will provide FRS along with use case document also. So after getting a use case document, we can understand the requirements very clearly. What we need to do? So clearly he will describe here in this section, that is use case document. Got it, ma? Yes, ask me. No, yes. Based on requirement, he will prepare the use case document. So how it will be, I will explain you today only. Okay. Customer want this type of application, madam. So for example, you want this type of application, just to tell me requirement. Based on requirements, I will prepare and I will give you. I will develop and I will give you. So why I am asking, requirement giving or taking, both are difficult. It's not very easy task. So now you want this type of application. This is the application name is login application. You want this type of application. You should tell the requirements. Based on requirements, I will develop this application and I will give you. Tell me requirements. Yes, you want this type of application. Right. Okay. Now here is customer is giving one application. He is giving requirements. How it will be, we will discuss. So requirement understanding is very, very important, madam. First of all, each and every software company, they will give nearly 30 to 40 days for only understanding the requirements. So why they are giving 30 to 40 days? First of all, we need to know how customer expect, what is customer expecting. We need to know, then only we can do work for him. So that's the reason each and every software company, they will give more days only understanding the requirements. No need to do any other work. Just we need to understand the requirements very clearly. This is very small application. It will be our requirements are also, it will be very easy or simple and we can understand very easily. But whenever you are working with a software company, that application will be big and they will give number of requirements. So just you should concentrate and you should understand the requirements. So it is very, very important. What is customer expecting? What he want? So we need to fulfill the, all the customer requirements. So if you want to fulfill the, all the requirements, or if you want to satisfy the, all the customer requirements, so compulsory, first of all, what he want, we should know, then only we can do work for him. So that's the reason software company, they will give more days. They will give more days, and once again they will explain you like how to understand the requirements. They will give training. That is the training period. The training period means if you have 10 years experience also, once again if you go to any software company, once again they will give training and how to understand the requirements, how process, which process we should follow, everything they will give you. So after getting job directly, they will not give any project. So first of all, they will give some time. So in the time, we need to understand the requirement and that software company, what process they are following, we should know, then only we need to do work with that particular project or company. Okay, right. So customer wanted this type of application, so he will give some requirements. Before going to requirements, so if you want to prepare the use case document, we need four things. If you want to prepare the use case document, we need four things. Actually, this use case document prepared by business analyst, to no need to learn. But if you know use cases, test cases will be very easy. If you know how to prepare use cases, if you know, then it will be, and the test cases concept will be, it will be very easy. That's the reason we are learning test cases. So up to now, test plan document prepared by test lead, use case document prepared by business analyst. Okay. Only test case document prepared by test engineer. Test cases we will write next class. Right. So if you want to prepare use case document, we need four things. One is screenshot, application screenshot. Application screenshot. We need four things. One is application screenshot. Second one is FRS, functional requirement specification. That means customer requirement specification. Third one is special requirements. Fourth one, use case template. We need these four things. Screenshot, application screenshot. Okay, already we have application screenshot. Next, FRS. Yes, just they will prepare the screenshot. Just it will be just like a rough idea. Roughly they will prepare, like not like this application. Just roughly they will prepare screenshot, like Paint, or they will use another softwares, and they will roughly they will prepare. Okay, So first, if you want to prepare use case document, we need four things. So this is the application, this is the customer want, this type of application. So first business analyst, first customer will give the requirements, how it will be, we will discuss. FRS, functional requirement specification. We can say functional requirement specification, we can say explicit requirements, we can say explicit requirements, we can say explicit requirements are given by customer. Given by customer, explicit requirements or FRS given by customer is saying first requirement, observe carefully madam. So this is the application you want, is telling requirements. First requirement is saying whenever invoke the login application, whenever invoke the login application, application should contain APLN, application should contain username, comma password, comma connected to fields, fields means edit boxes, fields, comma login comma clear comma cancel buttons, login comma clear comma cancel buttons. So this is the first requirement. Buttons type also is mentioning very clearly. Whenever invoke the login application, application should contain username, password, connect to fields, login, clear, cancel buttons. This is the first requirement. Second requirement, connected to is not a mandatory field. Whenever user requires you can select a desired database option. Connected to is not a mandatory field. Whenever user requires, he can select a desired database option. So it is not mandatory. Whenever you want, you can select it. Okay. Here we have some databases like master database, model database, pubs database, something we have some databases. If you want, you can use, otherwise you can leave it. So it is not a mandatory field. Okay. Third requirement, after entering username comma password, if we click on login button, corresponding page must be open. After entering username and password, if you click on login button, corresponding page must be open. Fourth requirement, after click on clear button, all the fields must clear. cursor should be placed in username field. Cursor should be placed in username field. After click on clear button, all the fields must be cleared and cursor should be placed in username field. After click on cancel, application must be closed. Application must be closed. After click on cancel button, application must be closed. After click on cancel button, application must be closed. This requirements given by customer. This requirements given by customer. This requirements given by customer. Next requirement, special requirements given by business analyst. Special requirements. Next requirements, special requirements given by business analyst. Given by business analyst. Special requirements given by business analyst. Special requirements given by business analyst. We can say explicit requirements. We can say explicit requirements. We can say explicit requirements. Explicit. Oh, no, 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 no. So first one, explicit. This is implicit. Implicit. Sorry. Implicit requirements. Given by business analyst. Given by business analyst. Given by business analyst. Given by business analyst. One second, ma. I'm getting one call. I will message him. Special requirements, business analyst, implicit requirements we can say. First requirement is saying, whenever invoke the first requirement, whenever invoke the login page, login page, login comma clear must be disabled. Clear must be disabled. Second one is cancel always enabled. Why is saying? Why is saying? Cancel button means at any point we can close the application. Cancel always enable means at any point of time. So after entering username, I don't have any good mood. So I don't want to work with that application. So at any point we can close the application. Cancel always enable. Third. So why is saying login and clear must be enabled? Sorry, disabled. Why is saying go here without any information? Login and clear must be disabled. So no, madam. If it is, for example, I am taking Gmail. If I give wrong username also, it will be login, it will be enabled. Wrong username also, it will be enabled, madam. Login button. Okay, here if you, without giving any information into any of the field, if it is login on clear, if it is enable or disable, no use. Okay, that is the reason customer is, sorry, business analyst is saying whenever invoke the login page, login and clear must be disabled. Next, after entering, username, comma, password, then only, after entering username, password, then only login button must be enabled. After entering username and password, then only login button must be enabled. After entering username and password, then only login button must be enabled. And fourth requirement. After entering any information into any of the field, after entering any information into any of the field, clear button must be enabled. Clear button must be enabled. Fifth requirement. The tapping header must be username, comma, password, password, username, password connected to login, comma, clear, comma, cancel buttons, So the tapping order must be username, password connect to login, clear, cancel buttons. The tapping order must be username, password connect to login, clear, cancel buttons. This is the requirement given by business analyst. This requirement is given by business analyst. Yes, for example, I need one website, madam. For example, I am going to one designer place. So after going to designer place, he will add some more points. Sir, Akhil Garu, just you are still in 1947. Nowadays, number of people they are choosing like this. So he will add some more points. Sir, now it will be, if you develop like this, it will be good and rich and class. He will say some more points. That is called special requirements. He will add extra requirements. Why? Because I'm totally new to that area. He knows something better than me, right? So you can add some more requirements. The requirements is called special requirements or implicit requirements. Okay, all right. Next, fourth one, we need use case template. Use case template we need. Name of the use case. Name of the use case. What is the use case name? Login use case. Login. Brief description of use case. It will describe the all the functionalities in the application. It will describe the all the functionalities in the application. Will escape the all the functionalities in the application. Actors, users. If it is any application, there are two users, madam. Actors means users. One is normal user, second one is admin user. If you normal user, if you enter username and password, it will open home page. If it is admin user, if you enter admin username and password, it will open admin page. Okay. So there are two types of users, madam. Normal user, admin user. If it is normal username, if it is normal user, if we enter username and password, it will open normal page. Normal means home page. If it is admin user, if you enter username and password, it will open admin page. Okay. And requirements, there are two requirements already we discussed. One is implicit, second one is explicit. Next, preconditions. Preconditions means, so compulsory developer based on the customer requirement, application is behaving or not. How we know? Compulsory that developed application must be available. That is preconditions. Next, post conditions. That preconditions means that developer application must be available. Okay, post conditions. Post conditions means if you enter username and password, it will open. If you enter correct username and password, it will open home or admin page or corresponding page. If you enter wrong username and wrong password, it will open. It will show you error message. What is post condition? If you enter username and password, correct username. If it is normal user, if you enter normal username and password, it will open home page. If it is admin user, if you enter admin username and password, it will open admin page. Flow of events. Flow of events. Flow of events. So main flow, alternate flow. First, main flow. This is the use case template made of. So first action, response. So if you do any action, what is the response coming? He will describe here in this section, madam. Response. Now I will tell you action. You should tell the response, madam. Actor enters valid username and valid password if you click on login button. It will open the corresponding page. If it is normal user home page, if it is admin user, admin page must be open. If it is normal user home page, if it is admin user, admin page must be open. Okay, main action. Action, I'm doing some action. What is the response? Based on the action, it will give the response. Only just if you understand the requirements, we can tell. Okay, actor invoke the application with following fields like username, password, connect to fields, login, clear, cancel buttons. Actor enters, actor click on clear button. And no. It should be clear and the cursor should be placed in username field. Okay, customer is said, okay, after click on clear button, all the fields must be cleared and cursor should be placed in the username field. And next, actor click on cancel button. Application must be closed. Application must be closed. Now, yes. Some applications having cross one, some application don't have. So here we have. So this is also cancel only. Cross one also cancel only. That application will be closed. But application having application the cancel button. So if you click on cancel button, application must be closed. Actor enters invalid username, invalid password. If you click on login button. Okay, actor enters only valid username. He checking login button is enabled or not. Login button enabled or disabled. Disabled. Why? Because customer is said after entering username and password, then only login button must be enabled. So here I'm and here he is entering only username. He is not entering password. So that's the reason it will be disabled. Actor enter wrong username, he checking clear button is enabled or not. Clear button enable or disable. Only is entering wrong username, he checking clear button is enabled or not. Enable man. After entering any information into any of the field, clear button has to be enabled. Okay. Okay, like we can write the use cases. So he will give use case document. So action response he will give you. So just we need to understand first of all requirements. After understanding the requirements, we also prepare the use case document. So that is use case document concept, madam. Just already you have soft copy, madam.